Hello friends, we will now look on some small part left in input and interaction, that is double buffering. Myself Sunanda Biradar explaining you. What is double buffering that we'll see now. When we want to display some computer graphics output on the CRT monitor screen or any display device, in order to maintain a sufficiently high frame rate in the range of 50 to 80 hertz, that is hertz is nothing but number of times per second the screen has to be refreshed, there is a possibility of observing some distortions in between by clearing and redrawing the screen. That means it is not capable to recreate the contents of the frame buffers at this high rate, and also not able to clear in the same rate. So one of the solution for this is double buffering. So the double buffering means is we are making use of two frame buffers rather than a single buffer, which we call as a front buffer and back buffer. The front buffer is placed when we draw in the back buffer. We can swap back and front buffer from the application program. With each swap, the display callback is invoked. So how to enable this is, rather than making use of a single buffer, when the content from front buffer are getting displayed, we can make use of a back buffer wherein we can just use it as a temporary buffer to store the processed pixel values. This can be enabled by using the glut double parameter in the glut init display mode function, where we used to have glut single in previous case. And as I said, it has to swap the contents of front and back buffers, right? So this is achieved through one of the glut library function, that is glut swap buffers. Double buffering does not increase the speed of processing, displaying the speed of it is not increasing the speed of the process of displaying, rather it ensures that there is no partial display visible on the screen, because almost it will reduce the rate of refreshing to double. The reason is 50 to 80 times, in the sense already it is constructing in the back side, just it has to transfer the data to the front buffer, that's it. So that's all. Then we'll see what are the need for design of an interactive program. This is the last part of input and interaction. So a good interactive program has to include the following features: a smooth display showing neither flickers nor any artifacts of the refresh process. A variety of interactive devices should be attached, variety of methods for entering and displaying the information, an easy to use interface, a good GUI should be provided. It should not require a substantially efficient effort to learn or make use of this. It should be able to collect the feedback from the user and should be able to tolerate the minor mistakes done by the users, that is something like pressing the any keys of the keyboard or mouse unintendedly, right? A design that incorporates consideration for both visual and motor properties of the human, like clicking a mouse button, dragging, dropping. So these all has to be included in a good interactive program. So many of you are doing animated kind of mini project. Just take care that these all features are included in your mini project also. So thank you very much. So that ends your input and interaction chapter. That is a larger part or one chapter of your fifth module. Thank you.